Working with the kids was in terms of the setup and the operation was just fantastic because that's one of those things in which when you're working with kids and you see the kids' reaction to the balloon actually coming together, to it actually being assembled, to the different parts of the balloon being assembled, for all of it coming together and the planning and the anticipation. That anticipation just becomes very, very exciting, not just for the students, but also for the teachers and for the professors. The first thing that happened is I got to the elementary school about 8 a.m. I had been there a couple days before and given them the meteorological equipment so that they could install it all in the gondola. We had a thermometer sticking out, and it was actually shielded so that it wouldn't receive direct sunlight. We had a camera, so it was actually looking out of the gondola so that we could actually get video. In the middle of the cooler, we actually had that's where we actually had the satellite phone, which was actually suspended above the surface. We also had a battery pack down in the bottom of the gondola, which actually provided power to the camera so that the camera would run continuously and it had plenty of juice. And wherever there was a battery, we had actually attached just regular handheld warmers that you can buy in Walmart that you can use when you're hiking. I bolted the equipment down so that the batteries wouldn't move and so that it would continually log. I programmed it so that it would actually automatically log and store the data every 10 seconds, and then from my standpoint, it was ready to go. Then we went outside, we filled up the balloon, a regular rubber balloon, with helium, and it was light enough and buoyant enough that it was able to lift the gondola, which weighed a little bit less than 4 pounds. We actually had to walk around the back of Columbus Elementary School, bring the balloon there, tether it to the ground, but also hold on to it because it was a little bit windy. We wanted to make sure that it wasn't going to blow up against the fence or against any trees or get smashed on the ground. We had to hold it there for about half an hour, and then we reinforced the gondola where the instrumentation was with duct tape. Once we had all those things strapped together, we were in cell phone contact with the other group that was at Edwardsville High School with a very, very similar balloon with a similar setup in terms of instrumentation and equipment, cameras, cell phone, global positioning devices, and we launched simultaneously on the surface. So what we actually do is by launching weather balloons is we can measure pressure at different heights, temperature at different heights, and relative humidity and dew point temperatures at different heights. And that tells us a lot. It tells us about the possibility of thunderstorms developing or whether or not we're actually going to have a nice, clear summer day. The problem is, of course, is after you do a balloon launch, hoping that you can find it. There were 8 chase groups. 4 were chasing the high school balloon, 4 were chasing the Columbus Elementary School balloon. Some people actually followed the track of where they actually saw the position of the balloon. Others followed where it was projected to land. We had mapped out the projected path of the balloon for that particular morning, given what time we were going to launch, winds of the day, and also what height above the surface we believed it was actually going to pop. I was in one of the groups that we actually chased where we actually thought it was going to land and projected it was going to land beforehand. And the projections actually came out to be pretty accurate. We were within about 20 miles of where it actually was projected to land. With the satellite phone, we were able to automatically map it and see its position on the ground and follow it. And that data can just every 10 minutes, we would get a position on each balloon, and we could actually track its path and where it landed. One of the things that happens as the balloon actually ascends is barometric pressure and the density of the atmosphere actually decrease. So one of the things that actually happens is the balloon, which had helium in it, actually expands. So down at the surface, it started at 8 feet, and then we believe it up at about 66,000 feet, the elementary school balloon reached a diameter of about 20 feet. And that was kind of like a rubber band. That was about as far as it could possibly expand. So it did go up above 60,000 feet for a while. But then it couldn't expand any further. The pressure was that much greater. The molecules had spread that much further apart. It just finally popped and fell back to Earth. When the balloon landed, and when the students actually did come across the instrumentation, they were jubilant. They were just extremely happy to see it actually land, for them to be able to recover it, to see that actually what they had launched in Edwardsville, they actually could actually find it in the middle of a cornfield in central Illinois. That was very, very exciting. And it was not only exciting for them, it was exciting for me. This really was the embodiment, I think, of education working on all levels. It was really the embodiment of education working in the elementary school level all the way up through high school and working with people at the university level. So it was a great collaborative effort, I thought, working with the elementary school teachers, with the high school teachers and students, and also with faculty here at SIUE, to see how we could all collaborate, synthesize our ideas, and make them all work together for the purpose of education. And this was one case and really one of the finest examples I've ever been in as a student or as a faculty member of seeing it all work. And for me, that was just absolutely an incredible experience and just really, really reaffirming that I'm in the right profession.